I'm goofing, brother. I'm goofing over here. Tuesday.
What?
You a sketch head?
You a sketch head yet?
You just got your shape up?
No.
Unfortunate for you, brother.
What are you doing? Like, what is the joke here?
There's a thing on TikTok. The only thing I've seen is it says girls go up to your man and say, "What's up, brother?" Like, what's up? I don't know the context. They just explained to me when you were over
what's
there.
What's up, brother?
Yeah.
Like this?
That's close. Yeah. You have a knack for it.
What's up, brother?
The voice needs work.
What's
Christian,
up?
Christian nailed it.
I did nail it.
What?
Do it again?
I'm in my head. What's up, brother?
Yeah.
What's up, brother?
Yeah. Oh. What's up, brother? Yeah, that's very
what's
good.
What's up, brother?
Yeah. Have you guys had a conversation with, like, I don't know, hexagenarians about Skechers recently? They lose their shit.
They love Skechers.
Dude.
Are we mad about the price of Skechers going up?
No, they're like, oh, I thought those were Skechers. This conversation I overheard was someone being like, oh, I like those shoes. I thought they were Skechers at first. Like, they are Skechers, but they were only $30. And they're like, lose their mind over Skechers.
Interesting.
Okay.
Interesting.
They're like the lamest form of shoe heads. What do the shoe heads call themselves?
Sneaker heads.
That sounds more right.
Shoebies.
Did you know that Snoop Dogg is a part owner of Skechers?
I do.
Or is
know
like
that.
A big like yeah.
investor. Really.
Investor in Skechers.
I think this is a Shaq general auto insurance situation.
Yeah. Doesn't Shaq also own Papa John's?
Yeah, he's a brand ambassador for them too. Yeah, he got in on it when...
He actually gave Papa John the pass, which is kind of fucked up. He got fired for it.
We're still waiting on that day of reckoning coming, really. Hello, 200 boys, 200 girls, and 200 non-binary folk. And welcome to the 200 Story Spectacular for the judgiest place on the internet. My name's Josh.
My name is Rick.
And my name is Christian.
And we are the Judgies. Back and...
Real quick, it says spot focus.
That's...
And welcome back from that bars and tone. Some people say...
I don't get it.
That wasn't
it. Bars and tone.
That's what it's called.
You have the tone of technical difficulty, and then you have the bars, the cleared bars, the bars and tone.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I get it now. Thank you.
Back in Aurora than ever. That's right, folks. Girlfriend of the podcast, on the podcast. Every 100 episodes, you get to make an appearance, and then some in between.
And a few in between. When we count wrong, you get to make one in between.
And someone to my left has complained that she has never gotten a poem, and she will continue to complain about that.
Oh, God.
Heartbroken.
Joshua, that is rude.
That's right, folks. If you're just now hearing about this, we are going to read 200 stories front to back, left to right.
Like, yes.
The 200, because we always get comments like, you guys do too many tangents.
Mm-hmm.
We want to do stories.
You really don't have a poem?
No.
That's a too tight of an episode.
That's pretty fucking rude.
Nothing rhymes with Aurora.
Dora. You are like king of slant rhymes, so
Aurora. It's a real like artsy poem. Take that back.
I'm not trying to bore you.
Is this a rap or is this a poem?
What's the difference?
Let's talk about something first.
I was trying to.
He was trying his darndest.
200 stories up, 200 stories down. We're going to get through them, but first we do have to get through the... Aurora, what is this?
You framed it like you had one.
That was a joke.
Cut it.
Cut next. The joke?
Yeah. Next.
What do you mean
I'm
next?
Sad.
This isn't an MTV reality show.
I'm sad.
Says next.
Next.
I feel like
I'm sad.
P.O. Box 58, Ottawa, Illinois, 6350.
Josh is in the doghouse.
I feel like a bad boy opening this envelope right now.
Why?
Because there's anime titties on it.
There is titties in there. Let me see.
Uh-oh, Erika's
Oh my god, you can't even see her face.
Erica's turning into a 15-year-old boy.
That's
She's
right.
She's got lips out too.
This
what?
Is
what?
Hentai.
What I thought she was wearing underwear.
She is.
That's pulled to the side.
Oh my god.
This is mail sent to us at our PO box, so do that if you want to.
We can.
That was awesome. You can use my name. It's Steph.
Steph.
She, her. I was listening to the New Year's episode and heard the listener who inherited cards but had no one to send them to. I moderate r/randomx of cards. Check it out. Crazy. This is
Holy
the second
shit.
Person.
Insane.
Wow.
A different Redditor sent me this very explicit anime sticker when I said I didn't mind NSFW stuff. Mm-hmm. This is one of the more mild ones. Jesus Christ.
Whoa. Wow.
Okay. I had like 50 to send, and I figured my favorite pod would appreciate a sexy anime lady. Thank you for making me sure. laugh. Steph.
I guess it depends on where you work, if it's NSFW or not.
Oh.
Like, if you work at a hentai production plant.
It's not safe.
Yeah.
Hentai production plant?
Yeah, like
a plant.
Yeah, like a plant where they produce all the hentai.
I have to argue with you here, Erika. I don't think she has lips out. I think that's just you're seeing her butt from the front.
No.
Oh, my God. That's actually really hot.
You're seeing butt cheek through thigh gap.
Absolutely. No, you are not.
Yes,
she's got too thick of thighs to have a thigh gap, and in the best way.
You don't know. You don't know about anime girl physics. This is insane.
That's correct.
One anime you've watched that's not Cory in the House.
That's very. Huh? It's very hard to tell.
It's butt cheek from the front.
What do you mean, Cory in the House?
The name an anime that's not Cory in the House.
But Cory in the House is not an anime.
Yes, it is.
Huh? Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. You've obviously never seen Cory in the House.
I think it's like a 2018 joke, right?
Oh,
it's a 28 episode anime, is what she meant to say.
Okay.
Editor. Well, it actually, I think Cory in the House is 34 episodes, canonically.
There's like a gray bar there, and I can't tell if that's like trying to censor her.
That could be censoring. That could be lip actually showing. I might be wrong. Mm. Fuck.
Anyway, I've seen...
Here you go.
What's that?
Promise Neverland.
Promise Neverland. And I've seen, what's the...
There's their boobs.
Death Spike Note. Lee.
Cowboy Bebop.
Cowboy Bebop. Yep. And I've seen
Spike
Death
Spike Lee.
What's his name?
Spike Spiegel.
Spike Spiegel. Fuck.
Jesus Christ. Lee.
You got Spike, though. I forgot his Spike. Name.
And then what did I just start watching with Lex? Was it Inuyasha?
Inuyasha. That's the one I sent you a TikTok of.
Okay, so
that
it wasn't that one.
A Shaggy Inuyasha collab.
What was the one I just started watching with her?
Jujutsu Kaisen. Which, who's your favorite character?
I'm only Toto? Like 3-4 episodes in, so not,
You've seen
I haven't
a
met
lot
Toto
more
yet.
Anime than me. I've only seen Cowboy Bebop
Cory
and or on High School Host Club.
I've also seen some Haikyuu.
Yeah.
Seen some of that.
Go off, Queen.
And I've seen some Sailor Moon.
So much more. Yeah.
And I've seen Totally Weeb. Spies.
Oh shit! Nah. That's not an anime.
That's French.
That's
animation.
So close.
In Twilight's to an anime, but tender not. Hue, Aurora wakes. Her laughter dances the dawn. She makes with eyes that shimmer like morning dew. She paints the sky in shades of new. Her smile, a beacon pure and bright, guiding hearts through the darkest night. Aurora, oh Aurora, a name so fair. She weaves magic in the morning air. In her presence, all worries dissolve. As she embraces life, problems resolve. Aurora, dear Aurora, a light so true, forever radiant, forever anew.
That's so nice. Did you not write that?
It's ChatGPT.
That's Josh GPT.
That just made it, you know, we moved on and we were doing better and you just made it worse.
That would have been such a hard flex to pull out that elegant fucking poem.
Yeah, instead I just stole it from other poets. Poets.
Poets.
Poets.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah.
Oh boy, you are being
what
a poet
do
by doing it with ChatGPT.
Ricky, a poet, a piece of shit.
Yeah.
I have this letter from Dylan that says that Josh is in the doghouse.
Crazy. Editor, trigger warning. Self harm.
says, my name is Dylan, and I'm an 18-year-old college student from, I'm not going to say, some tiny place in California. I love the show and started listening around 3 years ago. I don't know how to put into words how important your show has become to me. I have a horrible relationship with my family and have little to no friends. Every day in high school, I would sit alone in my car at lunch and listen to episodes of the show. At this point, I've gone through your entire catalog 4 times.
Damn!
You all keep me company, making me laugh on days where I didn't want to be alive. After my suicide attempt in 2022 at 16, I was at an inpatient facility for 21 days.
Editor, trigger warning. Self-harm.
The entire drive home, I listened to the show. I know it's strange, but I felt safe hearing your voices. Poop jokes have never been so funny. I got my shit together and graduated high school with a 4.0 GPA and am now in college working towards my bachelor's in science of nursing.
Let's freaking go.
Every week, I can't wait for the new episode, a chance to hang out with my favorite parasocial friend group. Ricky is never too political.
What the hell?
Least political
judging.
Thank
you. Thank you. I hope you all enjoyed your holidays and had a very Judgmas. Enjoy y'all's international trip. Josh, I'm so sorry for the loss of your precious pup. I have no clue if you will ever see this, but I hope you will. Thank you all again for making so many people smile. Hugs and pisses. Sincerely, Dylan. XOXO. Aww. P.S. Olsen is the most perfect name.
Got that right.
Damn. Thank you.
I am so glad that you're still here with us.
Thank you, Dylan. Yeah. We do it for people like you. Brave, wonderful listeners that have supported us all throughout the way. We appreciate each and every one of you.
We truly do. Mm-hmm. 200 episodes wouldn't be possible without you.
That's true.
Fuckers. True.
Aurora, you have a piece of mail.
Is there a thing? It's a gun.
Is there a thing with it? The plushies are in this bag because I live in Oregon. Oh my God, Oregon, and it's wet as hell up in this bitch. So they're protected just in case. I don't know.
What is that, little duck?
It's a freaking little duck on a swing.
Love that. That is so cute.
Oh, shit. Thank you, Josh. We'll do that.
Keep them coming. Keep them coming.
Holy fuck, it's a poem for Aurora.
Oh, no, it's a sticker. It's a hentai sticker.
Keep digging a hole.
Hello, Judgies.
Hello.
You're welcome to say my name. It's Mar, pronounced...
Mar.
M-A-R-E.
Mar.
As in margarita.
Oh, Mar. Hey, we're drinking margaritas.
We are. We are many margs deep. I've been listening since 2021 and love listening while I crochet, drive, and ride. That's an interesting...
Hopefully not all at the same time.
Ride.
Ampersand.
What the hell? You're doing this? You're doing this in the bedroom? You're
listening to a freaking podcast
in the bedroom? Brain freeze.
I decided to finally make some little plushies since the holiday rush is over. There's enough for each of you, including Aurora. They are machine washable, by the way. While I was making said plushies, I was listening to episode 175. During the circle dirge, Erika mentioned tansy. A little fun fact for you. Tansy is poisonous to horses. Another fun fact.
Oh, yes, it's a flower.
More than once, I have caught my horse sniffing tansy. I hate when my horses sniff tansy. No worries, though. We pull it straight away and the horses are safe once more. I've included a picture of my darling head empty, no thoughts TM horse, for your viewing pleasure. Please do not show the photo for circumstances that would take too long to explain. That's crazy that you can't dox your horse. It's a headshot of a horse.
It's a stolen horse.
There is no incriminating things in this image.
I need you to send the story as to why we can't dox your horse.
We need our privacy on that score. Anyways, thank you for reading and keep doing what you do. I will always remain a loyal listener. Love, Mar.
I want to hang this on my mic stand.
There are so many ducks. There's a big duck right here. This duck is white duck on a swing. There's a medium-sized duck that is yellow. And we have 2 small baby ducks.
That's me and Aurora.
That looks like a stolen horse.
That horse is very cute.
I am taking the red one. And then there's a little cream duck.
That horse is pretty cute, too. What the hell?
Okay, friends, choose your duck. Choose your duck.
Choose your duck.
Small white for Christian.
Obviously, I want the yellow one. How do I hang this on here?
Hang it on this little twisty guy.
Unplug. I would.
Right here.
Unplug.
I would either do what Aurora did, because that was actually very smart of her.
Just put a little twisty guy.
My little twisty guy is not visible. Locked.
Then I would unplug your XLR, maybe, and then just put it in there.
Right, because I know what
that is. Well, you found it first try.
I'm going to need you to do that for me.
I really appreciate that there's a creature for me that's very small. Also.
So now, Marks, we now need to read 200 stories.
Yeah. Yeah. We need to talk about my nails.
We do need to talk about your nails.
Yes. Okay. Display. So my BFF, Courtney, is going through nail tech school.
I'm pretty pissed off about it, too.
I thought we were all collectively your BFF. Your business friends?
Best friends forever. For now.
Business friend forever.
Business friend forever. Anyway, she's going through nail tech school, and she did custom Judgies themed nails. And so we've got... How do I get this to focus? I
put your hand... Yeah. What, are you not an influencer?
No.
Do this. So,
I can't...
You gotta cover your face.
Like this. There you go.
Okay. Here is the first one. It is supposed to be wall themed. So studio themed.
Oh.
Here's the next one. What the
fuck? We have to blur that.
Here's the next one. It's lip eye lip. And then this one was carrots.
Oh.
This one says... 200. I don't know if you can see it. It's 200 in little jewels. And then this one is the judgy's face. She fucking drew the judgy's face. Teeny tiny.
That's crazy.
Nails.
That's your face.
So proud of her.
I know.
Her.
That's what I said. Nuts.
Narcissistic.
No, it's your face. Speaking of carrots, though.
I've still got five left. Sorry. Each nail is different. Anyway, then in my left hand, she did MTB logo, which she is the inspiration behind MTB. And then we've got a shit one. It's a pile
poopy,
of shit.
Well, okay.
And it's got little flies.
And I'm the inspiration behind that one.
And then this one.
It's for Josh.
Is J for the Judgies.
Josh.
With like the 90s like
color
background. Josh. This one.
What is that? Like, is it Among Us?
It's like not focusing.
Sus.
Move your face. Anyway, it's eggs and cat paws.
Oh, one of our most famous stories.
And then freaking this one, brother.
That's your Coke nail.
This one, it's so hard to tell. I'll post a picture
this nail
or something.
Right here?
Would have been so much easier.
Yeah.
I'm going through each one because she worked really hard on this. It took her 12 hours.
Whoa.
Yeah. She did it all day.
There's only 10 nails.
What's
Come
the
on.
Last one?
She took a screenshot of like our like setup. And it's the headphones and our mic stand. And she even put the stickers that were on my mic.
Oh, whoa. My God.
She put the stickers on the nail. These nails are huge. Like, way fucking long. And I never wear long square nails like this.
Yeah.
So it's very difficult for me to do anything. But they're just, like, press-on ones that I can save as, like, a little in my little memory box. So, shouts out to Courtney because these were precious. And
thank you, Courtney.
I love her.
Okay.
Anyway, she does mine and Aurora's nails.
And now we do need to get into the 200 stories.
100.
Woo! It's going to be split between this and the...
Ooh. Weekly bonus episode.
Hated that. Speaking of carrots, though.
Speaking of carrots.
I got you guys a present because tomorrow is Easter.
Holy
and look at these
shit.
Little fuckers.
Those are so cute.
This is the first time Josh has gotten me anything in my entire life.
Well, anything you not remember. True.
Did you know that I love Reese's Pieces?
I love Reese's Pieces.
Really?
Yeah.
This is gonna ruffle some feathers.
You don't like Reese's Pieces?
I don't like Reese's Pieces.
Oh, well, more for me.
Yeah.
What's wrong with them?
We just bought two more today.
I don't know. I like peanut M&Ms and I don't like Reese's.
The thing
they're
is that's,
different and I don't like them.
They are different and that's the worst take. Like, Reese's Pieces are so much better than peanut M&Ms. Now, I mean, sorry, peanut butter M&Ms.
Ooh, that's the wrong take.
No, that's the
peanut
right take.
Peanut butter M&Ms are a lot fucking better. Because they taste like peanut butter.
I'm going to start muting everybody's
Reese's
mics
Pieces
if you fuckers.
Don't. They taste like it's a different nut. Whoops.
It tastes like a Reese's peanut butter cup. Do you think Reese's peanut butter cups taste like peanut butter?
Yeah.
It's processed garbage, and it's great.
So is fucking everything we eat in America. What are you talking about?
It's
all processed
garbage. That's what I'm saying.
Peanut butter, powdered sugar, and chemicals.
Yeah, the chemicals make it good.
The
M&M's has less chemicals in it.
I like the shell better on M&M's than the Reese's Pieces.
That's a fair observation.
You can take the shell off in your mouth and then eat the middle part.
I preach.
Why? Why would you?
Because sometimes
you eat the shell part, leave the little one and then eat the little one after you eat the shell part.
No. Yeah.
Here's what? How I eat my peanut butter M&Ms. I get two in my mouth, I crush them.
Nobody cares.
200 episodes, we gotta get. I get two of them, I crush them in my mouth, I have a little combat to the death, see which one survives.
Yeah.
And then once inevitably one gets crushed, the other one usually has a crack, and then you kind of, you, in your mouth, you chip away the shell, and then you have just the peanut butter thing. The peanut thing.
Circle in there.
Mm-hmm.
I...
Aurora gets it. You guys are fucked up. And
you got, no, you're... I understand. I also do that with peanut butter M&Ms.
No.
But
I just eat them.
Like how... I like how fragile a Reese's Pieces is in my Mises mouth.
I hated that.
But peanut M&Ms are goated with the sauce.
I agree.
Yes, they are.
This is also a hot take. I prefer peanut M&Ms over peanut butter.
What's your favorite color? What's the best color?
Yellow, obviously.
I'm a green guy.
Blue is really good.
Blue hits so hard.
You know what's nuts? They're all the same flavor.
I thought
you were going to say the peanuts.
But
it's nuts.
The yellow ones, the yellow ones look like they got more nut per capita.
Always. I think it's because
he's bigger.
The actor clearly a peanut M&M.
He's the hottest one.
He is fucking hot.
I think the orange.
The peanut M&M is the hottest one. Is that what you're saying right now? Like it's not the green one.
Well, they've had a desexified green one. They were too hot.
Hotter.
The green one got nerfed.
The green one.
She was too hot.
Anyway,
actually, they did a lot of work bringing in the hot brown M&M too, because I feel like they only had the green M&M for the longest time.
Sweaty glasses,
yes.
Oh
holy
my
fuck.
God!
Well, then they got the autistic M&M that came out like 2 years ago.
Which one?
The purple one.
Because
For the pretzel M&Ms.
And then the orange one with an anxiety disorder.
Is this a joke to Inside Out?
No, it actually does. This is Mars.
Got it. Joshua, can we talk about the sticker on your phone? That's a new addition.
Oh, yeah. This is Skinny Daniel.
I love Skinny Daniel.
This is from an Aurora Castelli original. This is
A sticker.
What's your Instagram handle?
Nobody can hear Crust? You. You're not talking into the mic.
Yeah.
What's your Instagram handle, Aurora?
Crust Toucher.
I always forget.
I hate that.
It's awesome. I love Skinny Daniel. Skinny Daniel's my hero.
Thanks.
I love Skinny Daniel. I love, is it like Coyote on a skateboard with a bag of money on its back? I love that one. I love Dog with the cowboy boots.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Stickers will be on sale soon.
You just posted a raccoon today, didn't you? Mm-hmm. Or was that yesterday?
That was today.
Today. Have you seen all of, there's a TikTok channel. It's just like a raccoon house. And it's just a video feed from the raccoon house.
It's Big Brother, but for raccoons.
Yeah, and there's just one big fucking raccoon that stays in there all the time.
Oh, my God.
And it's just, haven't I sent you these? And he's just like,
Aurora hasn't checked her TikTok messages in a month.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, see, that's okay. The problem.
And then I'm just like, every day the videos get, I see more and more. I'm just like, I get overwhelmed and so I just don't look. But it'd be so much easier if I just scrolled, like, instead of on regular TikTok sifting through, I could look at videos curated just for me by my friends.
Yes.
TikTok, write that down before you get banned.
a real for you
but
page.
Then there, so he's just like snoozing in this little box, right? And he is in all different positions and he like does these little grunts and groans and snores. It's so fucking cute. And then there's an albino raccoon that climbs in and tries to fight him for the spot.
No way.
And he just gets choked out every time.
He puts him in a Nelson
jiu-jitsu?
Yeah, it's insane.
Where's
my phone?
Does he use his little hands and just fucking... No way!
Yes, dude. I swear I've sent them to you.
The ones that look albino, they're called Lavender.
Really?
That is so cute.
That's some real Russian gray, Russian blue type shit. Yeah.
I'm pretty sure I'm right.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is that fucking cat not gray?
Yep.
Blue.
I have to agree with Aurora on that. I also don't open my TikTok messages a lot because
I have sent you so many.
Well, when you open TikTok, it like doesn't auto. It's like it hasn't auto refreshed like my message notification. So I'll open TikTok and it's like, oh, I don't have any notifications. I'm just scrolling. And then like 30 seconds later, it's like, oh, you have a message. Well, now I'm already in my fucking feed, dog.
Yeah, and I'm in the hole and stuff.
And it's not until I'm sending somebody a video and then I'm like, oh, now I'm in our chat. I'm like, oh, I just sent them the same exact video they sent me.
And she's locked you out of your phone.
That's a rat.
Look at that rat cussy.
This is excellent Foley work. Raccoons don't sound like that in real life. That's Foley.
Sounds like a factory. And there's that.
They're fighting. It's such a tame fight.
Yeah. You know, did you see him get put him in the headlock?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was so funny.
That's like the tamest, laziest fight I've ever seen. Yeah, anywho, tired. 200 stories on this episode. That's right, folks. We will.
I wasn't done. Real quick, he said. This guy shows up on my TikTok all the time, and I want, but he's got like millions of likes, so I'm like, oh, she's already seen it, and so I haven't sent it to you, but I'm just like, oh, they're just like fighting, and he puts him in a headlock. It's so cute. It's so cute.
I love it. Thank you so much for showing me.
You're welcome. And you're wearing a raccoon t-shirt.
Yes, I am. I was wearing a raccoon hat earlier, too.
While we were together, did we not notice this?
No. I had my hair in French braids.
Okay.
But I felt like my outfit and my hat made me look like I was 12, and I got really self-conscious about it. Mm, so I decided to put it in a clip.
Okay.
Instead.
Look at it. He's just like feeling around, and they're like, where? And now he's getting headlocked.
Why doesn't he learn? It's not his spot.
He goes in there all the time. It's so funny.
Anywho, so we are doing 200 stories.
Tight.
Episode 200. Can you hand me that aux cable? Because, of course, we did have a... None of these are listener-submitted stories specifically. They're all from Reddit. But we do have a listener-submitted sound submission.
But it's not the circle, Judge. It's not after this. Wait.
Sometimes we have to switch the formula up. It's an episode 200. This is a special event.
This is from Anthony Serrato.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Hey, y'all.
Northern Bones, baby.
Hoping I timed this right for the 200th episode recording, but regardless, congratulations. And for this special milestone, I've gone all the way back to July 2022 and reworked the first song I ever sent, inspired by The Wild Ride. That was episode 105. I'm so happy to have been a piss baby for all this time, for having the inspiration to create some silly, goofy songs, and the amount of support I received on my new album from this beautiful community.
We love that.
What was episode 105? What happened?
You'll see.
Okay.
One might even say you're the three pillars holding us all up with the goofs, gaffs, drama.
And laughs.
That's right. Here we go. This is from Northern Bones Anthony himself.
Josh, would you consider yourself the second pillar in me and Erica's relationship?
I would consider me the first one. And Erica's the second one holding up little baby Christian.
Are like two pillars holding up a monument, but without a pillar, a monument crumbles. Mm-hmm. I write poetry, so I'm very good at metaphors. I've been there for her through thick and thin. I'm going to be walking her down the aisle one day.
I want to know how old Audrey's dad is, where he's like, I'm gonna be walking her down the aisle.
Well, unless he's alive, which he probably won't be.
A true romantic, honestly.
I'm trying to be at her side, and Matt is at her other side. Gather the pillars, holding her up.
Get the pillars out of here, man.
I told you guys this was juicy. Incredible.
Fuck yes, that was awesome. Anthony.
Isn't that great? Incredible. We love that.
Everyone goes Northern Bones.
We do also have 200 listeners submitted sounds in this episode.
Sounds? There's a sound before every story.
That's nuts.
That's
we just went to Mom Jeans last night.
Mom Jeans!
The Midwest emo that Anthony Serrato played reminded me of our fun, super fun times at Mom Jeans last night with Honey and...
Somersault. Bad Hats.
Honey.
Somersault.
They were very good. Actually, every band was really good.
They were all fantastic.
I was thinking of Johnny.
Bad Hats.
That would inspire you
definitely
tonight?
Well, sorry we couldn't get to the 200 stories. Josh had to ruin the fucking vibes early on. So, no, but the Bad Head singer, she had the worst ADD. And between every song, she would be tuning her guitar and, like, trying to tell a story. And it'd be, like, 5 minutes between. And it's like...
She talked a lot.
I'm like, I'm loving your music. And she'd be telling her, she's like, so yeah, this song's about, and you could see her tuning her guitar, about the time I went on a road trip And I had to pick my favorite CDs for the road trip.
It sounds like a really bad Family Guy cutaway.
Kind of.
Yeah, a little bit. But we met up with Sal and Stacy.
Oh, fun!
Yeah, our Discord moderators. Yes?
Well, Stacy is.
You know, but they also...
Sal's off-submitter.
Sal is an off-submitter. You are correct. But it was really fun.
It would be really fucking annoying if, like, I went to it. It's like you're waiting for the thing to happen, and then they just keep interrupting in between and keep... Sorry.
Dude, it's I know. It's so annoying, right?
I couldn't imagine. This is our first story. We do have 200. If I don't get to the 200 in this episode, the bonus episode will cover the rest.
Okay.
Ooh, weekly bonus episode.
Patreon.com/judgiespod. Hey, Judgies.
Hello.
Snore.
Found this one just in time. They didn't tell us if we can use their name or not.
I need to read a little bit faster.
Found this one just in time for the 200.
Hold up. It needs to be
10% slower.
Found this one.
I just need you to. Oh, okay. Jesus Christ. I need you to
Jesus Christ.
I need you to think about, especially you personally, because you listen at 2x speed.
Yeah.
I need you to read fast enough to be engaging for our 1x speeders, but not too fast that the 2x speeders can't understand.
That's true.
I don't listen to podcasts at
1.75.
No, it's 1.4 with a silence out.
Josh?
Do you also use subtitles?
Well, not when I'm listening to a podcast.
Subtitles are in here.
It really pisses me off that you said 1.4.
It's too fast.
You're insane.
It's fucked up that Google gives you that ability.
It's fucked up that Google Podcast is ending in like a couple months.
Oh, what? Really?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Ooh, they're going out at the same time as TikTok. That sucks.
Yeah, for the same reasons.
Wait, so
China.
Google Podcast is like Apple Podcast. It's just like the Google version.
Yeah.
I think.
But they're ending, and you have to like you
why?
Can. It probably just wasn't like profitable for them. I don't know. Like you can export all of your shit to like Spotify now.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Can you go like 1x speed, 1.1, 1.2? You can go by point ones.
But the important thing on the app is you can skip silence. So like right now. I just had a silence, but if I was listening to it, it would just go, right now, I just had a silence.
Okay.
So it automatically shortens it more than the 1.4 times speed does.
That's interesting. Crazy.
So you're fucking up our attention time.
That was genuine. That's
crazy.
Wow. That's crazy.
So you know that sound clip where it was like, crazy?
Yeah.
Crazy, girl? Courtney and I do that constantly, like to the point where it's probably annoying to be around.
Yeah.
So my brain is just automatically like, you have to say crazy as condescendingly as possible.
Sure.
But I was genuinely like, wow, that's crazy. But then I was like, crazy. Yeah. Crazy girl.
Found this one just in time for the 200th episode where you read 200 stories.
Woo-hoo.
It's a quick one, so hopefully you can include it. Thanks, pisses, butts, and not giving a fucks.
Love that.
Pisses, butts, not giving a fucks.
Yeah.
Shit's pissed. Don't forget to tell your bitch. Is that what the other means?
Like, here's the problem. We really need to start writing these down.
I was just about to say that. Somebody needs to, like...
Not me.
Not me. I mean, Erika, I'm swamped, you're really.
Nose goes.
Double trouble. Aurora. Double trouble. Triple dibble. Moose. I can't. My margarita.
Am I the asshole for getting my boyfriend, 49 male, fired because I, 22 female, thought he was texting my best friend?
What job? What age? Wait, did they say ages? I wasn't listening to you at all.
Some of the only words I said were ages.
Yeah, I do get that. I was wondering about jobs.
49 male.
Okay.
22 female.
Age gap.
First time writing a story like this, so sorry for formatting. This is on r/ I'm an asshole.
And this was sent by a listener, not a listener submission.
Right, yeah.
Now, I'm just confused because you played an Anthony Serrato classic.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, it's already a classic.
Well, everything he does is classic.
Yeah, he's kind of like MGMT in that way. That's not... What's the name of that band?
What?
Baby,
what?
You're so classic.
Definitely.
That is not MGMT.
Not even close to MGMT.
Don't even say... Don't even say not even close.
It's not close.
Don't even say it. Genre-wise, sound-wise, it's not. But the
Tame Impala.
But the...
No.
Oh, Glass Animals.
Also wrong.
Oh, Milky Chance.
Also wrong.
Oh, Diplo.
Wrong.
Oh, Jack Harlow.
Pitbull?
By MKTO. So don't come in here that it wasn't even close.
MKTO. I've never even fucking heard of this band.
Baby, you're class and baby, you're sick.
No, like, what the fuck is this?
Hold on. Before I get too mean. Before I get too mean. Error, do you know this song?
No.
Okay. Yeah.
Joshua,
was that a good impression? Was that a good impression, or was that
a bad song?
Was that just you saying the
me
word?
Me saying, "Baby, I'm class. Baby, I'm sick."
Yeah.
Well, let's see.
Insane that I skipped right to where it says it in the song.
Impressive.
Did you fucking plan that? There's
song,
no way.
Not impressive. Bad song.
What's MKTO stand for?
It's a great song.
It's
the intro didn't make any sense.
None of us have heard this song. This is not a great song.
Out of my head, losing my mind.
No, that's not the song.
Wrong time.
You're thinking of Kryptonite by Three Doors Down.
right.
Malcolm Kelly and Tony Oller?
That's stupid
as fuck. I get why they went to MKTO.
They met while filming the Nickelodeon television series Gigantic?
Never heard of it. That sounds like a fake show that would be in a Nickelodeon show.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. And then later in the documentary.
Were they featured on Big Time Rush or something?
And yeah, exactly.
They opened for BTR.
I want to get you like Prince. Erika knows the song!
Erika, you just fucked it all up for us. You fucked it up so bad that our street cred is gone.
The one guy looks like Joe Burrow.
So. I don't know who that is either. Is that football?
Football player? He does.
Quarterback for the Bengals.
You, honestly, neither one of them. It could have been either.
Yeah.
Well, Do you think it was MK or T.O.?
Don't know.
Okay.
Anywho, T.O.'s a different football player. All my football heads will love that one.
Which is who?
Huh?
All my football heads, he said.
Terrence Tony Owen? Odell. Thomas.
Terrence.
Terrence Odom Jr.
Owens. T.O. His nickname is T.O.
First time. I'm getting pretty T.O.'d over here.
First time.
We need to get to 200 freaking stories. I need you to learn how to read through me.
First time writing a story like this.
Okay.
So sorry for formatting.
Dude, can you stop interrupting
it's
you?
The margaritas.
Dude, they're pretty
good.
You're
classic.
I'm probably going to need a refill soon.
Also, obviously, we need to get to the break before we refill.
Fair.
Also, obviously,
we're 43 minutes in, Joshua. When are we doing
allegedly?
A break?
Holy
shit.
We're probably like 33 minutes in.
Okay.
Allegedly.
We have to get at least 100 more stories.
I the asshole for getting my boyfriend, 49 male, fired because I, 22 female, thought he was texting my best friend?
Insane age gap.
Do we think he's an asshole? I don't think he's an asshole.
First time writing a story like this, so sorry for formatting. Also, obviously, this is a throwaway account, and I've changed all of the names.
Nobody cares. Go on.
For any spelling errors or grammar mistakes. Normally, I'm pretty good about that stuff, but under these circumstances, I'm not really sure they'll take priority, LOL.
Get to the point.
That was necessary.
Typical Redditor.
My boyfriend.
Real quick.
Luke.
No, real quick. No, listen, real quick.
Wait. Yeah.
Us as a podcast, can we agree to just, skip that paragraph from now on?
I wish I could agree to this.
What if there's an important piece of information snuck in there?
I'm dumb.
A piece in there.
That's
the problem.
Christian is like, Aurora, you're rules brain.
I'm rules brain.
You have to read as written.
Thank you.
That's
but I'm also a context reader, so I only paraphrase what I read.
My boyfriend Luke and I have been together for 4 years.
Luke is a bad name for a 49-year-old.
You said 22 female?
Yeah.
4, 2, 1, 0, 19, 8. That's 18?
Unless they rounded down.
Your ring is pretty.
Thank you.
I love how dramatic that was in a good way. Like, it's so pretty.
Thank you.
Very princess-y.
It is an emerald cut emerald.
Oh, yeah.
It's not a trillion cut, but it's three little round diamonds. On each side. Yeah. They're not real diamonds. LOL.
Do we think that Emerald got its name from the cut, or the cut got its name from the stone?
The cut got its name from the stone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we think that Emma got her name from the stone?
Joshua.
My best friend Nadia and I met as freshmen. We both rushed
in high school? Because, go on.
You can't make best friends in a single year is what we're trying to get at.
Yes, we're going to break.
Actually, today is mine and Courtney's 1 year friendiversary.
Why do you know that? Why do you know that?
I didn't, but Courtney did.
Makes more sense.
Yeah.
See, I'm
is she a better friend than me? Question mark.
No.
We'll get to we'll pick up the story on the other side of the break.
Are we actually taking a break?
Yes.
Yeah, I do need more margarita.
Insane.
Why are you so mad at me?
Insane that you need more margarita already.
It's really melted! Good!
Welcome back to the side of the podcast. We will get back to the story, but I do have
a circle jerk. Circle jerk. What the hell? It's the circle jerk.
I do have a circle jerk that I poured my heart and soul into. So we do need to do it.
Okay.
We will get to 200 episodes. I promise, folks. 200.
We're already at 200 episodes.
200 stories.
He poured.
I misspoke.
I do like pointing at things with these nails, I gotta tell you.
This is the episode 200 circle jerk. Been in the works for 8 weeks plus.
8 weeks.
These are things that would have been different if there were 200 of them.
Ooh.
Oh, interesting.
I love this concept.
200 towers on 9/11. Either a lot more deaths.
Whoa.
Or only 1% of World Trade Centers were taken down.
Hmm.
And then it's kind of not that.
And then it's like, okay, but there was 198 that didn't
remember.
we will forget.
A bit of a rough start to this segment, I gotta tell you.
Yeah.
Rough landing on that one.
It's our anniversary.
Really? Boo.
At least he thought of you once this episode.
Who?
You.
The next one, 200 Spartans instead of 300. Xerxes would just wreck them, and Gerard Butler wouldn't seem nearly as cool.
Hmm.
I do fear that 200 wouldn't be able to block the pass of Thermopylae. Thoughts? The hot gates of Thermopylae? Loser!
Is that a euphemism?
Are you talking about the Spartans? Because they lost? I mean, they're technically losers, but did you see how hot Gerard Way was?
Butler?
Gerard Way is hot.
Thank you. I think he was in 300. Well, he was in 200.
Gerard Way?
Gerard Way is the
lead singer of My Chemical Romance.
Gerard Way is the Leonidas in 200.
I think he was in the movie.
Yeah.
I haven't checked IMDb in a while, but I think.
He said, "This is the Black Parade." And then he kicked the guy down the.
I knew. I thought I knew it.
200 letters in the alphabet.
Can we get that remix, though?
Anthony, bud, we ask everything of you.
Somebody make that happen.
Make what happen?
I want visually Gerard Way's face,
yep,
superimposed onto Gerard Butler's face,
yeah,
in the scene where he looks over at Lena Headey and she gives the nod, like, kick this man into oblivion.
Headley.
Can we talk about the fucking crazy ass filter in that movie?
Yeah.
Yes. And then
that's the grease filter.
All
there's
you
the Mexico
hear while
filter
that exchange is happening filter. Is the da, 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 like, yeah, leading into it. And then as soon as he says, "This is the Black Parade," and he goes, "Bah!" And then it kicks in right into it.
I think you should do it.
Yeah.
No talent.
I learned how to rotoscope for once in your life.
That's why I'm on a podcast.
I think, and this is going to be controversial, I think you could teach AI to do it.
Probably.
It's gonna look bad, but it'll be a concept for what you're thinking of.
Right.
200 letters in the alphabet.
Be fucked.
Imagine how fucked English would be with almost 10 times more letters.
Imagine how many fucked up extra letters the English would put into shit. Imagine Color Now with a fucking U in it. Imagine six more fake fucking letters in there.
Instead of GIF or JIF, we'd be arguing shit like Glorfix or Glorfisks.
That's ugly.
That was dumb.
That was an ugly joke.
That was actually really highbrow and smart.
I didn't write it. That was off the dome then. If you guys didn't like it, is it more impressive if it was off the dome?
No.
Is it less impressive if I wrote it?
It was actually bad all around, so.
I disagree, Josh.
200 gecks?
There we go.
Even crazier music. Real difficult to understand shit.
Hyper, hyper pop.
A geck?
Do you know what 100 Gex is?
The band?
This is crazy.
The duo?
Uh-uh.
We use...
They're
what?
Huh?
Let her speak.
What? Huh?
He's trying to.
I'm trying to let him speak. I'm done.
They made a song that really popularized the term Piss Baby.
Yeah.
And arguably could be the reason why our fans are called the Piss Babies.
Okay.
200 flavors in Dr. Pepper. Imagine what that would taste like.
How many flavors are there now?
23. I think... I don't think the human brain could handle another 177 flavors.
Great math.
Thank you.
200 Judgies listeners.
We'd be back to square
one. We'd be so rich.
Well, we were actually above square one at that point. We were at about square four.
200 minutes in a year.
That's not enough, right?
It would be really hard to sing that song from Rent.
200 minutes
in a year. Yeah. Erika loves musicals. She loved that joke.
600
Now that you bring that up, Christian was in a theater class in college. And
what? I had to take it.
It was a gen ed.
But still, how is this? How did I not know that you were in a theater class?
And I greatly enjoyed it.
Why weren't you a theater kid after that?
I was more of a stagehand kid than a theater kid.
You were honest. A best boy.
I'm a best boy.
Okay, anyway, he got extra credit for going to see SIU's production of Rent.
Okay.
And he made me freaking go too. And it was terrible.
This sounds like an Erika retelling.
I just don't know if I made you. It feels like I had to go.
This feels like a real Erika FOMO situation.
What else am I going to do?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
The one play that I've seen in... like live, was in high school. I went to go to a musical of How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. And I went because we got extra credit for going for my speech class, I think. And it was so good. I was like, man, musical theater is sick. And
then it's not.
Never been to another one.
Yeah, because it's actually not good.
I just don't get... Have we ever dug into what your beef with musical theater is?
What happened to you?
It's just... bad. It's not entertaining.
But like
the music,
do you understand motifs?
But like, just like if I sang about everything I'm doing,
but that's
and
not
how I'm feeling about it.
But that's not what they're doing.
But it is.
You're describing music in general.
But yeah. No.
Here's how a musical goes.
I'm washing these dishes in my
That's not how it goes. How a musical goes.
No, that's how it goes. I've seen Rent. I was there.
A character feels emotion so greatly that they have to speak it. And then speaking it doesn't do enough. Then they have to dance. Dancing doesn't do enough. So now they have to sing their emotions.
Yuck.
Do you not feel the buildup?
Did you know that I did theater in high school?
This is fucked up.
Yeah, we've talked about this because you played
Madge Burns.
Madge Burns, yeah.
Madge Burns. I'll never forget.
200 teeth? Imagine if we had 2/3 of the chompers that Mr. Wonderful has while he shits on people's hopes and dreams.
Who's Mr. Wonderful?
The guy from Shark Tank, Kevin O'Leary.
He's got 200 teeth?
He's a shark.
Do sharks have 200
teeth? They have 300 teeth.
Fuck.
200 teeth would be 2/3.
You gotta keep up with the mess.
3 layers.
Okay, so question.
Yeah.
Do we have 200 teeny tiny little teeth? Fucking jaws.
Well, according to Animal Planet's Most Extreme, we would have giant jaws.
Okay, next question. Do we have normal sized teeth, but they line the entirety of our esophagus?
I think we do.
Oh my God.
And we chew all the way down.
I think we don't chew all the way down. I think we do multiple rows.
Multiple rows.
Because I've seen Naruto.
Okay, I have not.
This is a submission from Christian himself.
We love a sub.
200 Dalmatians.
Interesting.
I feel like people wouldn't have minded Cruella's coat ideas as much if, like, she would have gotten away with it if only a little less than half the Dalmatians had to go.
No, that's fair.
Because honestly, 200 is too many to take care of. Yeah. 101 was kind of irresponsible to begin with.
Well, really, it's only 99 more because you already had Pongo and Perdita.
Yeah, and I was wondering that. Is it only 99 puppies and then the two main dogs?
Yeah, because you only have to find 33 treasure chests in Kingdom Hearts.
And you find 3 in each?
Yeah.
Okay.
Did the mom Dalmatian die?
No.
No.
Okay.
And what were they? Pongo and Perdita?
Perdita?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. They're French.
They're so cute. We just watched that like not that long ago.
Really?
Aww. I didn't.
Have you seen Cruella starring Emma?
I haven't. Is it good?
I remember thinking it was okay.
Yeah.
It was we saw it in theaters.
Could have been worse.
But we love Emma Stone. I realized that was like our first foray into like watching Emma Stone together, and we love Emma Stone.
I've seen Easy A and stuff before
but,
that.
No, I think it was after.
Into the mic, please.
We've watched a lot of... I'll fix it in post. Mm-hmm. We watched a lot of Emma Stone together. And I, we right. both really enjoy Emma Stone.
Her newest
yeah.
movie?
Yeah.
Oscar snub?
No, she won.
Well, I was talking about the other movie. Dancers of the Flower Moon, Killers of the Flower Moon, Dance.
Oh, the other one was an Oscar snub. I gotcha.
Yeah. Well, that she personally orchestrated.
Did she?
I mean, you saw her face.
Oh, I see. No, she orchestrated the snub. 200 bits in gaming consoles in the mid-90s.
That would have been revolutionary.
If we had the Nintendo 200 instead of the Nintendo 64.
Okay, that's what's going to be my next question, how many bits were there?
Have games like Super Mario 200, Donkey Kong 200, need instead I say more? Instead of
64.
Super Mario 64 and Donkey Kong 64.
Oh.
Do I need to say more?
Yeah.
Gex 200.
What is that?
Hell instead of yeah. Gex 64.
You've never played Gex?
Harvest Moon 200.
There was a Harvest Moon 64.
Bomberman 200.
Okay, we get the concept.
Bomberman, actually, I love that game.
Road Rash 200.
Brother.
Road Rash 60. I don't think the... Out of the next one, brother.
200.
Enough of this one, brother.
You're going to love this one, Erica. 200 planets in our solar system.
Oh.
My very eager mother would have to eat in a lot more than 9 pickles. Let's just say that.
Hey, if that's happening, I'm going to need the 200 letters in the alphabet.
These are really good jokes, guys.
Did you write that down?
Yeah, these are all written.
Oh, that's actually embarrassing. I think these are off the dome. So,
so sad for you.
You took time to write these.
Fuck. Do you need to see my calculators that I do have in the drawer that
and
I collect?
And now are these first draft or 200th draft?
200 countries.
Next question. Is it?
That was a good joke too, guys, and we just glossed right over it.
I glossed as a bit. They glossed as little
shits. I wasn't listening to you. I didn't even hear what you said. I was calculating my own joke. I was going to do a DBC first and talk about Casios.
I have a Casio.
I
does it count up to 200? Fuck, that is numbers we don't even can't even imagine.
Wow, he can't even find it.
This is fucked. Did you see the comment saying that TI-89s, which I said were still expensive, are still expensive? They're still like $89.
Wow.
Yeah, but they're not $150 like they were when I had to buy one. Except for I didn't buy one because... Got it for free.
I'm telling you, when I bought your replacement one, since I lost the first one that you brought up,
yes.
We all know I'm a piece of shit, we get it.
Yeah.
I bought your replacement one for $90, so.
Hmm.
I did have to buy yellow, which is an off color, is probably a not very commonly bought color, but your favorite color is yellow, so I figured it was perfect.
Yes, I enjoyed more.
The price of one were so cheap that I had to buy it twice. Price so nice, I had to buy it twice.
With all your CVS money, I'm so sorry you spent all that. On a calculator. We don't even have any more.
This one here has a nice little leather case.
A lover's case.
This is a Casio Function 7000 GA graphics.
You guys, this episode is chaos.
It's nice.
That looks so...
Editor will take care of it.
Vintage.
This yeah, it looks so nice. Sick.
We'll just read a bunch of and stories on the
this
back.
This
we'll
is
cut
a
in the
TI 81. And you can see how much worse it looks.
Yeah. Can you get Jumpman
because
on
it's
that?
Not a TI 89.
Jumpman.
Name it up to something.
Do you think Drake wrote that song about the game on the T-89?
No. That was yeah. Boxman. 200
is Boxman?
Yeah. 200 countries.
You sure? A Jumpman is what Mario
how
used to be
called. How many
countries
do we currently have?
Like well, that's funny because I wrote down, I don't think much would change if that is drastically higher or drastically lower than the real number. Because I don't know how many
we
countries
have more than
there
200.
Are. Capitalism would still be a hellhole.
290. What if we only had 200 bones in our body?
We have 206.
Hey, maybe I wrote that down.
Oh, fuck. I'm sorry.
We would have babies six have less like, teeth.
Babies have like, or what if we had more teeth but less ear bones?
Or we, our finger, or our, we wouldn't have as many fingers. Ooh, we would have you, three.
Why do we have so many bones in our hands and feet?
Wasted bones in the feet.
Wasted
so
we bones.
Can break them.
We have one bone to go from knee to hip, but we have 30 in our toes.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
So we can do this.
All right, that's actually pretty hot.
No,
that was actually kind of.
Because of boobs? I don't understand.
200. There's only a couple more. 200. We do need to get back to the 200 stories.
Shit.
200 sided dice.
Have you seen 100 sided dice?
Mm-hmm. It's almost
it's
a sphere.
Wild.
Imagine that, but times two.
It'd have to be
it would
so
be a sphere.
Big for it to even like.
Or the numbers are just really small.
Well, I guess. I don't know if this is true, but I feel like it would take a really, really long time to stop rolling.
Do we think a 200-sided dice is a non-Euclidean solid?
It's not. It's definitely not.
Okay.
I don't think Brennan Lee Mulligan has a box of doom that can live up to the 3-minute rolling around of effectively a sphere is all. Goku's power level being 200 in the Vegeta saga.
It's normally like 9,000.
Vegeta never says it's over 9,000 in this instance, and DBZ probably never gets popular because of that. Because that moment was really the only thing the entire series gave us.
That's true. I don't remember another. R.I.P. Akira Toriyama.
And the last
one. He was 200 years old, though.
That's crazy.
He was 200 years old in anime years. Do the math.
Yeah.
Wait.
200 Pokemon.
How many are there actually? That would
be epic.
1,151.
A lot.
200 Pokemon. That's when they peaked. I've always said they should have stopped with Mischievous.
You know what I mean? Is that number 200?
It is number 200.
Did you have to look that up? Or did you know? Of course.
No, Josh is a fucking nerd and he knew that. It's okay. This is a safe space. You can let us know.
Do you still play Pokemon Go?
All the time.
Oh. I don't play Pokemon Go, no.
When did you stop?
Probably in like 2018. I started playing it again in like 2020. But
during
only
the big peak during COVID.
But only for like a month or two.
Hmm. And then he played Animal Crossing all the time. And then he stopped because
everybody stopped.
Yeah, because everybody stopped.
Holy shit. You have a gift.
Thank you.
You should hear his Nicolas Cage. Wait, which one is it?
Who is it? There's no way.
I don't know what a Nicolas Cage impression would look like.
No, what's the impression you do all the time?
Let's ride.
I have no idea.
No. It's Robert De Niro.
Let's go, brother.
Nice. Still don't get it.
I don't either.
I don't get it.
All right, back to the story. This is for the fellas. How many have we read?
Not one.
Okay. We got to finish. We do need to get 200 stories.
You have to do a listener submitted story.
I told you there wasn't going to be any at the beginning of the episode.
I wasn't listening to you.
Oh, you were because you had very big objections to it.
Oh, well I stand by that then.
You were actually listening very intently.
So this is back to, am I the asshole for getting my boyfriend, 49 male, fired because I thought he was texting my best friend?
Well, you start from the top. I know that was the title, but can you actually start from the
top? Yeah, well, that was the top.
After that, but skip the stuff that we agreed to skip the stuff on.
My boyfriend Luke and I have been together for 4 years. Mm-hmm. He's the love of my life, and I only want the best for him.
Ew, Grandpa Luke is such a... Luke is not a good...
We are now caught up.
Okay.
To where we were.
Okay.
My best friend Nadia and I met as freshmen. And then you said freshman in high school. Mm-hmm. It's implied freshman in college because we both rushed a sorority and hit it off immediately.
Could you imagine having sororities in high school? Like, there's not already enough cliques.
More like geek life.
My name kind of rhymes with sorority.
Ooh.
Would you look at that?
No, it doesn't.
Roar!
The Aurority. what do you call the Aurority?
Did you guys have Greek life at Southern?
Mm-hmm.
Did you guys do anything with it?
We walked through when they did the rush thing. Mm-hmm. We walked through the student center when all the sororities were asking people to join.
Yeah.
The only one that even stopped me to talk to me was a group called TKE. And this was their first year being back as a fraternity because they got shut down for roofing girls. So
Theta Kappa Sigma?
Yeah, that sounds right. Maybe Epsilon? I don't know.
Ah, it might be Epsilon.
But it's like a hard sell to be like, hey, I know we got shut down from doing some whack shit, but like...
My roommate...
We're different now.
My freshman year was in Alpha Gamma Delta.
Do you guys want to hear a crazy story about a sorority?
Yes.
A fraternity, sorry.
Yes, okay. I do.
I went to Eastern Illinois University.
Boo!
For a trip.
Actually, I've never been
there. Where is Eastern at?
Charleston?
Charleston. That's where Illinois? Jessica's from.
Which is where the original Jimmy John's is.
Yes.
But I had a friend who was, he transferred there and he got into a frat.
Okay.
And so me and friend of the show, Jake, from the Halloween episodes went. We were college roommates, of course. So we drove down. Really? It's like 3.5 hours to get there from Naperville. Maybe okay. It might have been like closer to 4. Get there, and while we're driving there, there's this other guy named, give me a J name.
John.
Yeah, I was also going to say Jonathan.
Great. There's only like 3, and the other one is him. And the other one's Josh, so.
Okay.
Joel.
Okay, there's 4.
Jeff. Javier.
5, 6.
Jasper. Jose.
7, 8.
Julian.
9, Josiah.
10. Fine. So they start.
Wait, I thought we were trying to get to 200.
We drive John's truck.
Okay.
And they start drinking on our way to this frat party in the truck.
Which is legal because you guys are in Missouri, right?
It's not legal, and I didn't partake. I was in the backseat. So we're getting there, and I'm like, guys, I really don't think we should be drinking before we get to a frat party. That seems like a bad thing. And they said, you're an idiot. You don't know what you're talking about. And I was like, guys, I've been to frat parties before, not to brag.
But two fucks.
You don't want to be the drunkest person at a frat party is what I said to them.
Correct.
Because it's a bad situation to be in.
Mm-hmm.
We get there, and they're already kind of buzzed. And Jake wasn't drinking, I should say. It was just John that was drinking. We get there.
Was he driving?
Jake was driving.
But John's truck.
Yes.
All right.
So John was already buzzed, and I was like, stupid. We get there. It's just like 18 dudes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And our friend isn't even there, I don't think. Or maybe he was. Not important. But we have to pay $10 for a cup. So we all dish out $30 for a cup to drink from the keg. And we start drinking. It takes an hour and a half for people to start showing up.
Mm-hmm.
And by that point, John is like pass out drunk.
Mm-hmm.
Is this short, John?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is such a John move
It's such a John move.
Yes.
He is, yes, very John move. So the party starts to get going and he's so drunk. I'm like, dude, we need to get you outside because you're making a fool of yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So I go to help him out the back and he falls down the back stairs and spills his beer all over the owner of the house.
Oops.
And so immediately the guy's like, out. You're kicked out. Bye. And our friend that we went there for, see name, guy.
Kobe.
Chris.
Kobe. Like the Jack.
Kobe.
That's yeah. Colby.
Kobe.
Colby.
Kobe comes over and he's like, I'm so fucking sorry. That's the guy I invited. You know, let's fucking.
Saving face.
Like, please, please, please. He's like, that's fine. Don't let him embarrass me again. So we're like, sick. Cool. John, calm the fuck down.
Did that work?
I don't know. I do not have recollection. This story is very long. Do not have recollection of him for the rest of the night. So it must have worked.
Because okay.
I don't know where he went after that. So out of nowhere, 3 guys, all pieces of shit. A guy that I was roommates with who was a massive piece of shit. M name?
Marvin.
Marvin. Mustafa.
Matthew.
Mark. Mark comes in with Greg, and I fucking hate both these guys. We're like, how the fuck did you guys get invited? They're from our hometown. Like, oh, well, fucking, what was the C name?
Kobe.
Kobe invited me. We're like, sick. Now we have to watch over this guy. We don't like Mark because he is an actual R-worder.
Yep.
An actual R-worder that I'd already signed a lease with, which fucking sucked. So he shows up and like immediately starts drinking and starts like hitting on girls.
Of course.
And so I'm like trying to keep an eye on him while the party's going on. Jake is getting high with somebody else's weed.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. He does random weed at a party.
Allegedly.
At a frat party.
Allegedly.
Which is not a great idea.
That shit was wet.
It was wet, I think.
Are you sure it wasn't just like dank?
I don't think so. Shit was wet.
I'm pretty sure it was laced with something.
Yeah.
Oh.
Gets dipped in something else.
I did not know that's where this was going.
But
I just knew that dank means uncomfortably moist.
Yeah.
And I also know that that's a word for weed.
Yeah.
I thought dank just meant it stunk.
Yeah. That means it's usually good weed. It's like dank weed. Stinky weed.
Well, the actual definition of dank means uncomfortably wet.
Oh, usually a dank basement stinks because it's a wet basement.
Yeah.
Because it's uncomfortably wet. Yeah. Anyway.
Jake starts to get into a fight with this other guy from our hometown. Like, he pushes him up against a wall because the other guy told Jake he was looking small in the arms. And so he started, pushing him up on a wall.
Does this feel small in the arms?
I was trying to get drunk the entire night. But you know when you're trying to get drunk and shit keeps sobering you up?
Yep.
So, this party's getting rowdy. the owner of the house is like, guys, we got to shut it down. We can't have this party here. So our friend Kobe comes up. He's like, guys, there's a sick place over here that my friends are at. We'll go to this party. He has this friend that just wore a Dale Earnhardt like actual jacket and just was a sober driver and drove people around. Sick dude. Drove us to this other party. I'm like, sick. It's going to take like 15 minutes to get there. I look over and Mark is just walking away with a girl after aggressively making out with this girl for like 15 minutes in public. And so I'm like, what the fuck is this? Where did Mark go? And Kobe's like, I have no idea. I was like, that's unsettling to know.
Yeah.
We get in the car. Mark gets in the back seat with a different girl. And then Greg was also in the back seat. I'm in the shotgun passenger seat. We all go to this other place. And it's like two twin
and twins
apartment buildings. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
We go up in the one. And we have to walk up like four or five flights of stairs. And it is like dudes getting high and drunk playing FIFA.
Okay.
Which is an insane vibe to walk into uninvited.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I was going to say that could be a vibe, but to be the
kickback.
Yes. It was not a party. Not a rager. No. So we all walk in and Jake's like, sick. No, it wasn't FIFA. It was NHL. So Jake just starts playing hockey with these people. I go to the bathroom. It's like a his and hers sink. One of the faucets broken off.
Mm.
Have I ever told you guys this story?
No.
This is an insane story. I don't think
it's very long.
I've told you this story. Mm-hmm. I'm like halfway through. I've shortened it.
You have.
I go into the sink, his and hers sink, into the bathroom, and one of the faucets is just broken off and spraying water.
Actively.
Actively. North. Whoa. And then onto the counter.
Oh my God.
And on the counter, there's a wallet. And I'm broke at the time. I'm not happy to admit this. I look in the wallet. There's also a cell phone next to it, completely soaked in water. There's 10 bucks in the wallet. I'm like, guys, I need $5 for a sub at Jimmy John's. This has been a hectic night. I took $5 out of the wallet. This is the
OG Jimmy John's. I have to eat it.
I took $5.
All right.
Sue me.
I'm actively doing it.
Stealer.
At this point, Mark had showed up to the party, and then he disappeared again because he came in with that girl. Actually, that's not true. I skipped a very important part. Mark was in the party. I always describe this as there was three people dancing at this party. There was a guy leaning on a table, a girl dancing on him, and then Mark dancing on that girl.
Ooh.
Everybody else was
like
not.
Like they
doing
were
it.
A sandwich.
Yeah,
but clearly Mark was not invited to the sandwich.
Oh my God!
I was trying to have a horseshoe, and you turned it into a sandwich.
So nice. So I go in the bathroom and come back out. Mark is gone. No idea where he is.
Okay.
And I'm like, that's, again, disconcerting. What the fuck is going on?
Concerning. Not disconcerting.
It was very concerning. This was concerning.
Okay.
Shut the fuck up.
Frankly?
Frankly, this was concerning. We're there for like an hour, maybe. Because I'm not just trying to keep eyes on Mark. I'm keeping eyes on Mark. I'm trying to keep eyes on... John, Greg. I'm trying to keep eyes on Jake. I'm trying to keep eyes on everybody. And
mother.
I was very mother that night. So we go outside and it was like March-ish. So it was like kind of cold out at night. And we're outside and we're waiting for a ride to Jimmy John's. I could look down the alley and see Jimmy John's. It was like maybe three blocks away, but for whatever fucking reason, we're standing there waiting for that same guy to come around and pick us up for Jimmy John's. It's been maybe 2.5 hours at this point. It's like 3 a.m. And we don't know where Mark was. I look over and out of the other identical apartment building, Mark, I see him stumble out. I recognized his gait. It was like pitch black. I recognized his gait because it's somebody I've known for years. And I look over and I'm like, Mark, is that you? And he like drunkenly looks at me and then comes over crying, nose bleeding profusely, snot, and crying.
Good.
And he says, I didn't even fucking touch her, man. And I'm like, Mark, what the fuck happened? And he wouldn't say anything. He was too out of it. And his nose was broken.
Sounds
so,
like somebody that touched her.
Yeah.
Sounds like it. So I push his nose back. I like hear it crack because it was very broken. And so I just pushed it back. And then
you were in pre-med at the time.
I was technically. So then we have all go to Jimmy John's. Greg and Mark are like best friends. Mm-hmm. Nobody likes them.
Mm-hmm. Either one of them.
And Greg is like, well, I want to go in Jimmy John's, but somebody has to stay with Mark. And I was like, I'm not staying with Mark. So I go in. Eventually, they just come in, and Mark is just on the table like this, like drooling and snotting onto the table in Jimmy John's. And I go up to the counter. I'm like, do you have like a glove that you could fill with ice so I can give it to this guy? His nose is broken. And they're like, no, I don't. And I was like, that's fine. I don't give a shit. And they're like, by the way, have you seen somebody walk out of here with a table? And I said, huh? And mind you, there it's like 3 a.m. There is like 12 Jimmy John's workers at 3 a.m.
Oh, they know.
And they go, have you seen somebody walk out with a table? And they point and there's just a table missing.
That's so funny.
And I'm like, no, I don't. And they're like, okay, cool. Sorry, we can't give you a glove. I'm like, that's fine. I'll have a number 5. LBI, no tomato. Add hot peppers.
LBI.
Get my sandwich, eat. We finally, this is like 3:34 in the morning, are like, we need to go sleep. It's been such a long night. We go into Kobe's dorm room, and we get up there. It's me and Greg and Mark and Kobe and Jake and
John.
And Kobe's roommate is black. And Greg walks in and says, what the fuck is an N-word doing in here?
Holy fuck.
And I look at Kobe and I said, I am leaving. I cannot be here. And so after drinking all night, stone cold sober, I said, John, I'm driving your truck home. I don't care if you're coming with me. And he said, no, I'm going to stay here. So me and Jake get in the truck at 4 a.m. and leave. And it is a 3-hour drive back to our hometown and then another 1.5 hours back to Naperville. So I just start driving.
Did Greg stay?
Yeah.
The roommate let him stay in his room after that?
Wow.
Yeah.
And what the fuck?
And his roommate was awake and he definitely just like pretended like he didn't hear it.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
In your own fucking room, too.
Jesus Christ. And like a fucking stranger just comes in and says that.
Yeah.
What can he do, though, in that situation? Because it's one stranger with like five guys that he doesn't know.
Yeah.
It's like he can't do much.
Yeah.
Especially like 5 drunk dudes. Like, unfortunately, you can't do much.
So we get in the truck. I don't feel drunk at all. Like, I probably hadn't at that point had a drink in like 3 hours. Still would not recommend driving. This was not a glory story for me.
Sure.
A lot of things went wrong tonight. And I am not saying that I was a good guy in any of these cases. I start driving home. And it's pretty much all interstate driving. And I get to the last long stretch on 39. Mm-hmm. It's a very big interstate that goes all the way through Illinois. Well, mostly through Illinois. And I get on that stretch. And I'm just blasted. Jake's asleep the whole fucking ride.
Of course he is.
He like all 4 hours he's asleep. And
passenger princess, obviously.
I have music blasting, trying to stay awake because I've been up since 6 a.m.
the previous day.
Because I had to go to work at the animal shelter. 6:04, by the way. So I'm blasting music, trying to fall asleep. And this is the only time I've like hallucinated in my life. The black tar of like filling in cracks were like coming to life and turning into alligators and eating me. And in my mind, I was screaming bloody murder, freaking out. But outside, I was just driving straight line, 70 miles an hour.
Just clocked in.
Just like, I need to continue. We pull into John's driveway. And it was just me and Jake. John stayed there. He later got upset with us for leaving. And I was like, fuck you.
Yeah.
And Jake wakes up like 10 minutes away from when we got home. And he's like, oh, do you want me to drive to Naperville? And I was like, yeah, I would appreciate that. Because I need to sleep. I'm actually pretty freaking tired. We pull in. We left my car in our hometown. He's like, I'll just drive you around for the next week until we come home. You can grab your thing. So I get in his truck in the passenger seat. And I'm like, oh, I'm going to sleep for 1 hour and 15 minutes. It's going to be sick. And I stayed awake the whole time because Jake fell asleep 200 times at the wheel. And wow. I woke him up 200 times at the wheel as we were driving back that last hour. We finally get to our apartment. There was supposed to be nobody home. We had 4 roommates, me, Jake, Mark, and then this other guy. Finally get to our apartment. It's like 6:30 in the morning. We are exhausted. We've had a hell of a night, to say the least.
Mm-hmm.
We unlock the door, push the door open, and the fucking chain hits. And I just look at Jake and start... I just slump to describe what I did. slumped to the floor. Mm-hmm. And I said, I can't, man. I'm going to fall asleep on our bear's doormat. Mm-hmm. And we're banging on the door and we're calling our other roommate because apparently he was there. And after like 20 minutes, he opens the door and goes, "Hi, guys." Because he's a very cheery guy. And we said, "Juice, get the fuck out of our way. We're going to sleep." And then we slept. And then we watched football. And then we slept some more.
You had to wake up for the football game. You couldn't miss that.
Yeah, you had to wake up for that.
And that is the craziest night of my life.
I do have one editor's note.
Yeah.
And I get it would kind of ruin like suspension of disbelief here. But yeah. I feel like when you said 13 times, I feel like you should have said 200 times just thematically for this editor.
200. And I woke him up. 200. Okay, thank you. That was my experience with frat life.
Can I tell you about my experience with frat life?
You'll know your cue. We gotta get back to this story.
All right. Yeah, no, that's fine.
Boyfriend Luke, I'm a dealer for 2 years in my life. My best friend Nadia, I've been a freshman. Funnily enough, I also met my boyfriend through this frat. My big just happened to be I have the hottest dad, and we hit it off 4 years later, and I'm Mrs. Luke.
Hang on.
Huh? Yeah.
Hot dad.
This is the dad of one of your sisters?
Yes.
What?
Sorority sisters.
Oh.
Yeah. That's how they met. So Luke works with the recruiting branch of the military, specifically the ROTC.
Okay, come on. I makes gotta
sense.
Tell
you. It makes sense.
Okay.
Let's hear a little more of the story.
It makes sense.
They have a relatively big presence on my alma mater's campus, so he frequently is messaging with students and whatnot to direct them to get more brave soldiers to protect our nation.
Sure.
Really cool. This definitely ties into my story here. Hey, let me tell you about my frat story, which... I don't know. Does ROTC count as a frat? I would say it's a frat.
It's a brotherhood.
Cult. Really?
Really?
Aren't they all?
But I had a friend that was in the Marine ROTC at U of I. I took the train up to visit him one weekend, and it was like... Part of it's like, that was such an experience. I'm glad it happened. It was the most terrifying like 24 hours of my life.
Yeah.
It was chaos. I show up to U of I... I get to his apartment. He lives with like 8 other Marine ROTCs.
That's terrifying.
Whoa!
And the floors that you, when he like came to get me, he's like, "Hey man," and just like, "You gotta leave your shoes on through the apartment." I was like, "That's a weird thing to be like warned up front." I walk into his house and it feels like walking on like a glue trap. My shoes are like coming off of my feet. There's just so much shit spilled on the floor. And it's like, what the fuck, dude? But we proceed to, like, we pre-gamed at their apartment. Just a bunch of fucking, the rowdiest dudes I've ever seen.
Sure, they're all Marines.
They're not even Marines yet.
They're pre-Marines.
They're pre-Marines, and they're trying their hardest to be seen as Marines.
A pre-Marina of sorts. Pokemon heads are losing their shit.
You can still get pregnant from pre-Marine.
True judgy.
But, so, we're throwing this, like, pregame at his apartment.
Still get pregnant from pregame.
At some point, people start showing up to this pregame, but they're not knocking at the door. They're coming in through the balcony. People are climbing up 3 stories of balconies to be like, "Ha-ha, surprise, fuckers!" And it happened multiple times. Whoa. Where it's like,
one time is funny.
Yeah.
3 times is concerning.
It felt like this has to be a common thing. And it's like, I think they just spread the word that it was funny, and now they're like, "I'm gonna do it too." It was insane.
It's objectively hilarious.
It is objectively hilarious.
I guess.
We proceeded pregame there. At some point, the person that it's his apartment that I'm at. Do we want to give a name? Alex. We'll say Alex's apartment. At some point, Alex disappears from the party. I see him, like, pull out his phone, get on his phone, and then just walk out of his apartment. I was like, where the fuck is he going? And I try. Like, I'm maybe 15 feet away. I finish my drink. I slam my drink, put it down, and go out the door, and he's just gone. And so I walk outside, like, to the street, and I just see him running down the street.
What did you do with your drink?
I put it down.
Do you want
to... Oh, I went... Alex, wait up. And then I go out into the street. He's just running away from us. And I was like, And I have one other friend that came to the party with me.
I have a story with the same guy where we hung out and he just fucking sprinted away from us while we were drinking.
He was a runner. He was a track star.
Why? Yeah. Why?
That's just how he was back in the day. But so he's running off and I'm like, what the fuck? And eventually, like, I'm trying to call him. He's not answering phone. Eventually, he answers his phone and he just goes, he just tells me an address and then hangs up on me. And I'm like,
what?
I'm in a town I've never been to.
Didn't even ask if you had a pen and paper ready.
No. Never been in this town before. Turns out it was editor redact this name. Fraternity House.
Which is the exact same frat I was at the night that he ran away from me.
So weird. So I show up to this house and he's just fucked up. It's insane. We party there for a while and then at some point he's like, this other ROTC house is having a party too. Let's go there. We go to a third house. This one is like an actual house. And this is when it gets too much for me, honestly. We go to this house. Everybody's drinking. We walk in. People are in their boxers or in whatever their, like, PT little undies are. Like, wrestling. Like, greased up.
PT little undies greased up?
They're like, greased up wrestling each other. Like, and it's like, what is going on here? And it's just dudes being bros.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay.
We've all been there.
And then it's like, oh.
Surely. Like, who of us hasn't?
It's like, hey, these people are smoking downstairs if you want to go smoke real quick. And it's like, go downstairs. I go downstairs, and there is somebody with, like, a handgun shooting into a wall, and I'm like, we have to leave. He is just shooting a gun in a house into the basement wall. Okay. It was fucking insane.
Like a cinder block basement.
Yeah. I'm like, what the fuck is that noise? And it's like, open the door, and it's like, a handgun. It's like, I'm like, I got him.
Was he wearing ear protection?
I don't think so.
That's your concern.
Of course he wasn't.
And what's weird is
boxers and earmuffs. Oiled up.
This kid was an MMA fighter and fought a kid from our hometown, too, which was like a weird small world event where it's like, I saw you kick that kid's ass. That's crazy.
Wait, like fought him in official MMA capacity?
Yeah. And it was like, and so we leave. We go back. We leave.
Either way, I'm bleeping. Didn't need to cover the mic.
We leave and go back to Alex's apartment after that. I was like, this is too much. It was too much for me to handle.
That's a lot.
And it's like, I'm pretty drunk. I'm getting sobered up from the house is too much. The house is too much. We leave. I'm glad he let me leave because I was like, oh, I gotta go. We get back to his apartment. His roommates come back and are like, we're still partying. And they're telling stories about how they found roadkill and what they like. They got bet one of the ones to like take a bite out of roadkill, and they have a video of a guy.
A bite?
He took a bite out of roadkill.
That's so much worse than squelching. Was that what it was?
The what?
The eating a pie off the road.
Yeah.
Squelching, was that what it was?
Blanding.
Yes.
He took a bite out of roadkill, and it's like, what?
Well, how fresh, really?
I have no idea.
One question is how fresh.
I'm like, you guys are too much for me.
You could get fucking rabies from that.
I'm sure.
Only if you eat the brain.
What?
But.
Rabies is only found in brain matter, but also the number of diseases.
And then we wake up. It's me, Alex, and our friend Tom. We wake up to somebody coming into the room and throwing a shopping cart. It's like 5 in the morning.
Like a full size.
Like a shopping cart that they like.
Like a Walmart.
They lifted from Aldi.
And now that I'm talking about it, this
like,
is like
I paid for it, 25 cents.
Now I'm talking about it, this is all blurry in my head. I feel like this is what woke us up and they're like, you gotta see the video. And it was the video of him. It was us getting woken up by him throwing a shopping cart onto Alex's bed. And it's like, and it was just like, what the fuck's going on? And it's like waking up, and it's like they're all still going. It's like, what the fuck? It was the most stress I've ever felt in my life, I think. And I just remember like, and I was only there for a single day. We went there on Friday, we went there, and then on Saturday we all rode down on the train to SIU to go party in SIU. And I just remember the train ride. I'm like, I don't think I can ever go back. I don't think I can
I don't think you did go back.
I didn't.
18, 19?
Yeah, maybe 20. I don't know. Probably junior year.
Didn't he break his TV or something?
He was notorious. When Alex would get drunk, he'd either piss on his TV or he would get drunk and like play video games and punch a hole through his TV.
And he would piss on it?
Oh yeah, he was a pisser.
Ew.
He would pee in closets.
So was John.
Yeah,
John was a pisser. Oh,
he would pee in closets. He'd pee on like everything.
John stepped on my head one night to make it to the bathroom. I'm still pissed about that. fucker.
When, the reason why I asked, because I just remember in that house, Alex had like a big, like a 55-inch TV, which was big at the time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's still big now, but like at the time, that was like, holy fuck.
Yeah.
Because it was like 2013-ish. And I was dating Alex's sister. And I remember only hearing the part about how he broke his TV. And then his dad just drove down and bought him a brand new TV the next day. And I was like, that's crazy. You just bought him a brand new 55-inch TV after you just broke the last
one. Firstborn son, baby. Someone's got to pass on the name.
Really got to get through this story.
Oh, fuck. Sorry.
Do we need a recap?
No, just move on.
A great story, by the way, bud.
Thank you.
That there was some things in that story that I've not heard before, so there's we're going to talk reasons. About that later.
Hey, there's reasons.
I can understand that, but we're still going to talk about that later.
My weekend at U of I also blur insane, like I could not explain in words how I felt the weekend leaving. I was just like, what the fuck just happened?
Yep.
U of I is an insane school.
But SIU gets the bad rap for the party school. Sure.
We did
have riots and whatnot, but like
U of I is crazy. They have a relatively big presence on my alma mater's campus, being ROTC. I love my boyfriend, what he does, but here comes the problem. I'm recently graduated and working at a great 9-to-5 as an assistant office administrator for my dad's law firm. The pay isn't great, only 30 an hour, and the hours are long, normally anywhere from 20 to 25 hours a week, but I'm salaried, so I have to put up with it.
That's 25 hours a week. You're getting paid $30 an hour, and it's not great.
I'm salaried, so I'll just have to eat it.
Nadia didn't quite have the hard work I did to get such a good job post college, so she decided.
Wait, who's Nadia?
Oh, the best friend.
Best friend.
So she decided to go into grad school at the same college that we graduated from.
Faux pas, really?
No big deal, right?
Wrong.
Her program is working with military personnel for research on something confidential related to the royal family.
The royal, bro. Did you hear about Princess Kate?
Her BBL?
Her BBL?
She's not gonna fucking BBL. But everybody was giving her so much shit about, like, being, you know, out of the picture or whatever. She had abdominal surgery. Like, oh, you had abdominal surgery, but you were out and about 3 hours after giving birth showing the world your infant.
Which they, like, force them to do.
Which is insane.
Yeah.
Bad.
But then she hasn't been seen for months on end because of abdominal... Like... People were just giving her so much shit, and now she fucking has cancer.
Yeah.
And like, fuck you guys. Fuck you guys.
I will push back.
All right.
Because
she's rich.
No, she's a royal. She is not rich. She is a god amongst people. Mm-hmm. She's in the royal family.
She married in, so.
She chose to marry in.
I'm just, go on.
Like, I just feel like people, and like, she's a pup, like, she actively spends money from like taxpayers.
Mm-hmm.
So like they kind of need to know where their money is going. You know what I mean? Like if Biden just disappeared for months, we would all be like, why is he getting a BBL? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Also, what was up with the weird Photoshop?
Yeah,
that was strange.
It's hard.
The PR for the royal family is so dog shit.
It's bad. It's real bad.
The whole thing is a mess.
It really is a mess. I do feel bad for her because especially like having some kind of cancer, that
sucks.
That sucks. And that's such a private like thing to, you know, she probably hasn't even fully processed it herself and then has to go and tell the entire world like, hey, there's been a lot of rumors. Turns out it's cancer. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah. I would just feel worse for her if she wasn't part of the same family that like made Meghan Markle leave for filming a video outside.
Sure.
You know what I mean? For being black.
Huh. That's why they had to leave.
Well, no, but that part of the controversy was she just filmed a video as a...
It was the brown suit, actually. That's what made it.
Effectively, it was the same thing.
I mean, what if she does come out? She comes back and just has a dump truck. She just has a freaking dump truck.
It's an effect from the chemo.
It doesn't kill all cells.
People do gain weight from chemo.
That's true.
Some people do.
Yeah. She just...
And it just fortunately all went to the right spot.
Or is she getting Princess died? That's all.
I mean, yeah, right. Because the rumors were that her husband was like cheating on her. Which, sure. I mean, the actual royal family.
They got the Clinton gun. They got the Clinton heart attack gun. And they just set it down. They turned it down to cancer instead of heart attack.
Slow, miserable death instead of.
Yeah. Well, because King Charles has cancer too right now, right?
Well,
yeah.
it's a low like news cycle.
But that's to be expected. He's old.
Yeah.
They're trying to fill in the news cycle, so they kind of got to like let's stretch it out a bit. We got to get this to last the full season.
I shouldn't say that it's expected because he's old. Nobody should.
He should have died a long time ago.
But he sucks.
He has lived a lot longer than he should have. Let's say that. No big deal, right? Wrong. Royal family. She's been making excuses for not being to hang out, and it's getting on my nerves. Whenever we do hang out, she's always on her laptop working, but I sometimes see iMessage pop up and she responds. Whenever I ask who she is messaging, she gets really weird about it and just says it's her dad.
AKA... Daddy. Her boyfriend.
No, it was her big's dad that was her boyfriend.
Okay.
My husband has also been acting a little funny. Not wanting to spend money, hiding his phone when he's texting, asking if Nadia knows what kind of jewelry I like. And so I put two and two together and realized they must be messaging each other behind my back. I went to the ROTC office to confront him at work since I knew he wouldn't be able to run away when he got caught. But he wasn't there. His boss, Frankie, had said he had gone out for lunch with none other than Nadia about 45 minutes ago.
Interesting.
Uh-oh. I was flabbergasted.
How long's his lunch break?
I think I'd be livid, honestly. I'd be more than flabbergasted.
So I told his boss the truth, that he was cheating on me with her. This hit him especially hard because Frankie was Nadia's dad, and he didn't like that his daughter was running around with a guy as old as Luke.
What a twist.
Why would he be okay with them going to lunch together then?
I left and went home.
Again, how long is his lunch break? Because like 45 minutes into a lunch break, he should be heading back. He'd be there any minute. You can still confront him at work.
Well, he's anti-capitalist.
Girl's dad's there too.
He's an anti-capitalist ROTC recruiter.
All time theft's good.
I left him.
I feel like if you have an adult daughter, it's like I would trust them to be okay, like not be doing shady shit.
Adult daughter or okay
son? You trust
son?
A man?
If it's my best friend and his name's Luke, I guess so. I'm assuming it's best friends. Dads are best friends and daughters are best friends. It's heavily implied.
Except for it's not his daughter, it's his wife.
My wife.
Yes. I forgot about the age gap.
Yeah.
I left and went home. When Luke showed up, he demanded to tell me what I said to get him fired. And I told him the truth. Then he pulled out an engagement ring and said he had gotten with Nadia earlier that day.
To propose to her. Because he doesn't love you. He loves Nadia.
No, to propose to the person writing the story.
He got her best friend's opinion to help him get her.
He said what I did was unforgivable, but he doesn't see my side. I told him he could just ask his dad for a job, but he said his dad wasn't as well off as mine, whatever that means. So am I the asshole? I thought I was just telling the truth.
Yeah, no, you're a piece of shit, but so is he, so...
He was doing a nice thing.
He's 20 years older than her.
I forget about that part. It took us so long
27 years older than her.
That's insane. That's almost a 30-year difference.
That's almost as old as I am.
That is as old as I am.
Yeah.
You're 27?
Baby.
God, you're so old.
How many stories is that?
One.
Did you even?
Fuck.
Oh, I guess you did finish it, huh?
We will get to the other 199 on the
we
bonus
got
episode
more coming up.
It was so close to the fabled No Stories episode.
So close. Unfortunately, or fortunately for the listeners.
Or fortunately.
We will no longer have we still haven't had a No Stories episode.
Have fun cutting that for TikTok.
The fabled.
I was just going to ask about
that.
How?
We are posting old TikToks for TikTok this week.
Oh, we can't cut up us being funny. We're scared to show the world that we're silly goofy.
Yeah.
Fuck. It does suck. That it doesn't perform as well.
I mean, we're not doing great on TikTok right now anyway.
You haven't been for like 6 months, right?
Six
Why
months?
Why you gotta put on our face like that?
It's been like 3 weeks.
200 days?
It's been a minor blip in a little drop in engagement.
Well,
what are we going to do when TikTok gets banned?
Here's the thing. Do we
Instagram,
feel like
YouTube?
Quitting TikTok yet?
Start new podcasts?
How would that help?
I don't know.
That
does not help.
You can. I don't want to make this say, like, I'm not saying you can't, but that doesn't help.
What would I talk about?
It's like our biggest marketing thing went away. It's like, what if we started something new?
That was hard to market.
even harder because TikTok wouldn't exist at that point. That's how you guys got famous.
Unfortunately.
Anywho.
YouTube shorts and Instagram reels,
folks. We'll read some stories on our Patreon episode.
Yeah, we have 199 to get through.
Dude, it's going to take us so long.
If we all read one at the same time, we only have to read 50 stories.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I call 49. But you guys have to read 50.
Right.
And we'll do it. Remember how I brought up the quadraphonics?
No.
When did you bring that up?
Back when I did the bit of you reading a thing and me reading a thing and I did in stereo, so one ear was you, one ear was me. Well, then I brought up that, oh, Josh is like, well, I'll read mine too. And I said, I can't do that. I don't have quadraphonics like the Pink Floyd album.
Okay.
And so it's a type of recording where you record in four channels, kind of like stereo records in two channels, and you can get more depth in your audio. And I'm saying that we don't have that ability.
Does it go like Z axis?
I don't know.
Okay. So anyway, if you're looking to find more Judgies content, you can find us on the internet. Wherever you're on the internet at, we're probably there too. You can just look up at Judgies Pod, JUDGIES. If you want to send us some listener submitted stories or a listener submitted sound, you can do that at judgiespod@gmail.com. And then if you wanted to send us a mail, if you're so inclined, you want to send us a letter, a provocative sticker maybe, you could do that, or some cute little duckies on a swing that you made. You could do that at P.O. Box 58, Ottawa, Illinois, 61350. And if you've made it through this chaotic episode or through any of our other 199 episodes, we are so, so unbelievably grateful for all of you and making this a dream come true for us.
And if you want to follow me on Instagram to see creatures every Saturday that I draw, my Instagram handle is crusttoucher, all one word.
Store coming soon?
Yeah. Store with stickers and prints coming soon.
If you're really missing out on those 199 stories, go over to the
weekly bonus episode.
Bye, everybody. Thanks for coming around 200 times. That's almost as many times as the sun revolves around the earth before a year.
Yeah, almost as many.
Look at my nails.
Globocentric.
You
geocentric.
Bye.
Archimedes needs a word with you.
Archimedes can suck my ass.
Christian coming out on a flat earther.
Listen, I'm not a flat earther. I'm a geocentrist.
If you let Archimedes suck your ass and you don't let me, I'm going to be real mad.
Oh, bye.
Bye.
The judges love you.
Hey, so we did end up a little bit short. So for the next 2 minutes and 55 seconds, please enjoy a medley of our soundboard bits. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Good one, Joshua.
Tell me about that circle, George.
Mission failed. We'll get them next time.
Shut the fuck up, Josh. Shut the fuck up, Josh. Shut the fuck up.
Did you see it? Birdie, you earned a bronze medal. Challenge cleared. Chip in. Double eagle. You earned a gold medal.
DJ Birdie.
Great double eagle. Great eagle.
Marinated.
You beat the high score. Hole in one. Nice birdie. Nice shot.
This
you earned a platinum medal.
You earned a silver medal. Try again.
Says meats are meant to be.
Try again.
We have the meats.
Oops.
Cool. Doghouse. Doghouse. Doghouse.